If you want to learn how to dominate the conversation in just 3 days, then stand up and welcome to the stage, Mr. Peng Joo.
So by show of hands, how many of you would like to have a lot more income and impact in your lives? All right, thank you. You are in the right place. My name is Peng Joo, and today I'm going to show you how to make that happen by getting unlimited traffic in just 3 days. So here's the focus, our main focus today, right? Our focus today is I'm going to be showing you, the first thing is, how can you execute the entire conversation domination strategy in just 3 days? By the end of this short presentation, what you're going to get is a 9-step system whereby the only thing you need to do is step number 1, and step number 2 to number 9, you can actually hand it over to your team, the entire blueprint, the steps, and tell them, implement or die. Okay? That's number 1. Number 2 is, I'm going to be showing you what I did to reach over 2 million people, or build a following of over 2 million people on Facebook with over 100 million views. And finally, how I got an unfair advantage with getting crazy ROI by monetizing my following. Okay, how many of you would like to learn how to make that happen? Okay, thank you. So let us begin. I'm not going to spend 30 minutes talking about my life story. I'm going to just give you like the 30-second version. Basically, I am from Malaysia, a couple of blocks down the road. I do events, workshops, seminars all over the world. I've done events in over 20 countries, spoke and closed in all these different countries. That's basically what I do. So here's the main thing, right? By the end of the Expert Secrets contest, this was the week of the launch. We did quite a bit in that week. And at the end of the launch, the one question in everybody's mind was, who is Peng Joo, right? So I'm going to show you the actual strategy that got me to win this contest, right? Basically, what gave me the edge, even though there were people on the contest with a much bigger reach and much bigger following, was because over the last 2 years, I've actually built an audience on Facebook with a big reach. So this was a screenshot that I took just 3 days ago. Just last week, we got over 3.3 million reach from my post last week. So understand that this is during a time when marketers are complaining and crying about how Facebook is killing the organic reach. And I'm going to show you how you can get the edge during this time when everybody is... So it's basically survival of the fittest. If you can understand how to adapt, you'll be able to get an unfair advantage. So how did I make that happen? I made it happen by having a strategy, by utilizing what I call the content multiplier formula. Okay, so it comes in 9 steps. Let's begin. Step number 1 is basically you are going to spend 3 days shooting 120 videos. Now, I know that sounds crazy, okay, but here's how I do it. 120 in the 3 days, this is my man here, Ken Okazaki, where you can. So that's Ken. I spent 3 days with Ken, and during the 3 days, we shoot 120 videos, but here's what we do. We begin with the end in mind. I don't just spend and start off my day and think about 120 videos. My team actually brainstorms 120 different titles that we know will convert even before we shoot the videos. So there are a lot of tools that allow you to do this. For example, BuzzSumo. BuzzSumo has analyzed over 100 million headlines. And one of the things you can do is model headlines that convert. So what you're going to do is you're going to list out 120 different titles. So for example, I know it looks really small here, like will make you. This video will make you want to start your own business. This video will want to make you stop eating carbs, right? Stuff like that. Now, the way to make it good, Russell talks about this, is to have a polarizing message. Understand that there's no money in neutrality, right? So a safe message in the financial market would be, here's how to make more money. A good hook would be, here's the real reason why you're broke, right? Now, understand something. Know that when you have a polarizing message, what's going to happen is naturally, you're going to have people that will disagree with you. You will have haters. You will have critics. But know that it's either love you or hate you, but there's no money in between. Okay, so begin with the end in mind. BuzzSumo will also allow you to look through all different articles with really good engagement. So for example, if you want to BuzzSumo, you typed in red wine, if that's your market. BuzzSumo will list down all the different articles out there that has got great engagement with regards to red wine, right? So another thing that BuzzZoomers does really well is you can actually analyze posts on different pages to see which posts got them the most views and the most engagements. So this is how the top post of Russell Brunson, Tony Robbins, you can actually see what their top posts are to give you an idea. So don't just funnel hack, Facebook hack as well, right? Notice the ads, or rather the post with millions of views. Chances are if it's got a millions of views with very low shares, it means that chances are it's an ad. It means that this post has made the marketer a lot of money, and rather than trying to reinvent the wheel, model what's already working, right? So 3 days we spent, 3 days shooting 120 different videos. And the most important thing on this step is you want to be consistent with your messaging. You don't want to be talking about how if you're not hustling on Christmas Eve, then you're a loser. And then 5 days later, you're talking about how you're living the laptop lifestyle, you're on the beach, right? So Russell talks about polarity, right? Being polarizing, and not being bipolar, right? So it's two different things altogether. So that's step number one. Step number two, what's gonna happen is, so step number two is where you're gonna let go. If you're a solopreneur right now, you could be doing the steps, but this is where you wanna have an assistant or have your team come in and implement everything else, okay? So step number two is where you're gonna have all these videos uploaded on a shared network. So I personally use Google Drive, you could use Dropbox, you can have all these different videos uploaded into different categories. One of them is whether it's completed, if it's completed, or if it's posted, right? Next thing is you'll have it all in that video bank, all stored on the network so that everybody will have access to the files. Step number three is where your videos are going to be repurposed into all these different platforms. It's Instagram, YouTube, blog posts, quote cards, Facebook, Instagram stories. And what's gonna happen is, on this step, you're gonna get the videos, each and every single video transcribed. You can use a website like rev.com. They transcribe all of my videos because these transcriptions are gonna be used for subtitles in your videos. They're gonna be used in your quote cards. You're gonna be used on your long form post and your blog post. I'll talk more about in detail as we go along. One of the things you can do to cut costs, to save costs, is to merge all of the videos together, set it in one file, and have the entire file transcribed. So once you finish that step, step number four is where you're gonna get the videos edited on the different platforms. Now here's the thing, I've got 27 minutes and I've only got 19 minutes left, I've got over 100 slides. I want you to understand that from this point forth, the words on the slides are not for you. Everyone repeat after me. The words are not for me. You're gonna realize I'm gonna go real fast. There might be a lot of words on the slides. It's not for you. It is so that you can either take pictures of it, ClickFunnels, I've also sent my slide deck to them. They're gonna send it to you so that you can take the entire slide deck, the entire process, and give it to your team. Does that make sense? Right? All right, thank you. So you're gonna have the subtitles in the videos, you're gonna put the frames around the videos, you're gonna export them so that it's ready to be posted on Facebook, and once it's stored, you're gonna put it in a certain folder, right? Then, the social media platform requirements, these are different dimensions. Again, I'm not gonna drill into granular level, this is for you to pass it to your team, these are different dimensions. And once that's done, so notice, one video, this is the same video, right? Conversation domination. My video goes on Facebook, then it goes on YouTube, it goes on Instagram, it goes on Insta Story, but it does not happen on the same day. We stagger it so that people will see a reason to follow you across all these different platforms. I'll talk about how to stagger it as well as we move forward. So step four, 4B, is where you are going to have the video posted on all these different platforms, YouTube, Facebook, Instagram. So here's what happens. On YouTube, these are the dimensions. You're gonna have it uploaded on YouTube as well. Once it's uploaded, you're gonna put it in the respective folder. Again, this is not for you, this is for your team, okay? So I wanna show you conceptually the big picture on how to make this happen and how to execute it, right? So step number one on this step is once it goes on YouTube, you're gonna have all of them uploaded on YouTube, but it's all unlisted right now. So the public doesn't see it yet, it's all just queued up. And what's gonna happen is you're gonna create a playlist for all of these different videos that's not yet posted. Then on Facebook, 720 by 720, you're gonna have all of these videos on Facebook right, that's created for this platform, all queued up as well, and you're going to post them on Facebook. Then you're going to schedule these posts for your next 1 to 3 months. So like for me, I don't touch posting on Facebook, or my team, they just queue up everything. It's all queued up for the next 2.5 months, and I don't touch it until I shoot my next batch of videos. So that's one of the things you can be doing as well. I schedule all of my posts. So example, a Facebook post would be like some of these videos. These are my better converting videos that got over 10 million views, right? Not everyone is going to be a home run, by the way. Most of my videos, 5% of them take off, right? Most, like, and I'll talk about how do you deal with the ones that really take off. How do you really maximize and make the most of it? So your Instagram, again, the words are not for you. It, once you have the video created, 2 months later, it's going to go up on Instagram. Now, here's the thing about Instagram. On Instagram, you can't schedule, unlike Facebook, right? You can't schedule and queue it all up. So one of the things you can do is to use an app like Meet Edgar. You still have to post it when the time comes, right? So get someone in your team to assist you with that. So the video that goes on Instagram is actually a video that appeared on Facebook 2 months ago, except that Instagram doesn't allow you to post videos that's longer than 59 seconds. So you need your videographer to create a different version of the first video on Facebook and create a 59-second version. Then what's going to happen is, so for example, these are different videos on Instagram as video posts, right? 59 seconds long. And then from the videos, you can also create Instagram stories. So Instagram stories, they're 15 seconds long. You also want to get your videographer to create the 15-second versions of the full-fledged version, right? And this is where you're going to have that bank of 15-second videos to be posted as Instagram stories throughout the day as well. I do it at least once every single day. Then we move on to step number five. Step number five, we talked about quote cards earlier. What are quote cards? Quote cards are basically these type of posts. I have my, remember we talked about having the transcription? So now that you have your entire thing transcribed, one of the things that my writers do in my team is they will take the biggest takeaways that I said in that video and they will create all these different quote cards and post them throughout the day as well. So all these different quote cards that go throughout the day, we have a folder for it. Again, the words are not for you, it's for your team. Right? We have an Excel file of how things are done, right? So that we know when it was scheduled, how it's created, how it's repurposed. And then these quote cards, you want to use images of yourself. And you can create this easily through using websites like Canva, like PicMonkey, or if you're on the go, using Fonto, right? So this is for you to pass off to your team. Next, so you have your entire bank of quote cards that's shared to your entire team. And what's going to happen is step number five, Facebook. So you are going to queue up these quote cards on Facebook with a description, just like these quote cards have been all queued up for next 2.5 months for me, right? And these are all scheduled all beforehand, right? You can pass this off to your team. And on Instagram now, again, I don't post the same quote card on Facebook and Instagram the same day. I stagger it 2 months apart so that the content on Facebook and Instagram is constantly different, and there's a reason to follow you across all these different platforms. So you have your quote cards on Instagram staggered for 2 months, right? So these are some examples of the quote cards that's posted. So same thing with Instagram stories. You can take the quote cards. Remember, people, because we're doing it, we tend to tell ourselves, wait a second, but I've posted this before. Your audience, they don't remember. And even if they do, it's a reminder of your message. You're being consistent with your message. So be okay with the fact that you've posted it before. So even the quote cards, they're posted as Instagram stories. So for example, of quote cards being posted as Instagram stories that goes out throughout the day. Step number six is where you're going to create your blog post from your transcription, right? So you're going to be dominating across all these different platforms, right? So your transcription of every single video can become your blog post. Right? What you're going to do is you're going to send and take the transcriptions and post it on your branding website or your blog. Now, if you want to go one step further, this is what I do. for all of my videos that do well, that got over 100,000 organic views, I get my writer to come in and edit all these different transcriptions so that it doesn't look like a transcription. It looks like a proper blog post with the images and formatting and all of that, right? So you want to put it on your branding website as a blog post so that you get that long-term SEO, that link juice, right? Make it blog post ready, and then you're going to post it. Again, the words there for your team. And then now on your YouTube channel, you're going to edit the description so that it links to your blog post, right? So now you're having all of your content, you know, linked with each other, and you're building a really long-term, you have now a long-term content strategy, right? Now you're going to put the videos as public. You're gonna publish it, you know, one day at a time. That brings us to step number seven. You're going to now have your long-form blog posts, right? Now your long-form transcription, this is the part that's sick. Nobody else does this. So what my team does is they take the transcription, they put it on WhatsApp Web Messenger, and they put in these emojis throughout the transcription, and then they upload it on the shared folder again. Now, why would you want to do something like that, right? So they take the entire transcription, they put on all these different emojis, and then they upload it back to the shared folder as Instagram long form completed. And what's going to happen is when you post them, okay, so you're going to post it with something that you did that day. It's just an image. It could be casual. It could be you eating. You traveling, right? So it's going to look something like this, right? So it's just an image of what you did that day with the long form transcription. Looks like that. The reason why this is powerful, because it looks like you just sat down on your phone for like 15 minutes, typed up your thoughts, right? Super powerful, right? Nobody else is doing this. So once it goes across, so it goes on your Facebook, goes on your Instagram as well. I do this, one of these posts every single day, right? I put a link on my Facebook. I link it to my YouTube or whichever channel that you want to build your audience on, right? So Facebook post example, very similar to Instagram. And then it goes on to you move it to your posted folder, which brings us to step number eight. Step number eight is where you're going to use Instagram and create your polls, giveaways, story highlights, boomerang videos. You know what boomerang videos are? It's like, you know, those kind of videos, right? So so you're going to create all these different type of stuff, right? And once you get over 10,000 followers, you can be able to use swipe ups. So for example, example of swipe ups on Instagram stories would look like this, right? So this is all repurposed. You can shoot them beforehand, right? You can do a poll, right? This is how. So let's talk about timing. Again, I'm not going to go deep into timing. This is the timing that I personally use right now on Facebook. I post four times every single day. This is for your team to refer to as well. For Instagram, these are my times that we've tried in-house that's worked really well for us. Now, here's the thing about Instagram, though. So this is the thing that happens evergreen every single day once it's automated. But like what Russell says, when it comes to stories, look, Instagram is about lifestyle. So we want to create content that matches the context of the platform. So these could be the content that goes on Instagram, but for the rest of the day, you're just documenting your journey. You're just creating your stories. You're just shooting the videos because people want to see the mundane, boring stuff. They want to see the daily stuff that you do, and what you're eating, where you're traveling, all of that kind of stuff. So in other words, this is the big picture, right? Now, everyone, you should be taking a picture of this. Anyway, you'll be getting the slides anyway, but so this is basically the eight steps. Step number one, where you shoot a video. Step number two to eight, you're going to send it to your team or your PA or your digital assistant, right? And have everything streamlined and automated so that you can be dominating the conversation. Which brings us to step number nine. Step number nine is, you could be thinking, so what's the ROI, right? What's the purpose of building this following, getting all of the likes on Facebook? Because I went to the bank and I tried to bank in my Facebook likes and they didn't want to accept the check, right? So this is step number nine, is showing you how do you get your return on this investment on your efforts, right? How many of you would like to know where the money is, right? Do me a favor, turn to the person next to you, give the person a high five and say, show me the money. So here's the ROI. Now, as you are shooting all these different videos, What's going to happen is initially when you're starting out, it's not going to, the reach is not going to be big. I'm going to be showing you how to get the big reach eventually. But understand that when you post these videos and when you get views that can be boosted, this is the biggest game changer right now. The biggest game changer is you can run ads to people that watched at least 50 or 75% of your video. Do you know how powerful this is? Now, here's the biggest change that has happened in the last 5 years in the internet marketing scene. Marketers have always said, the first thing you want to do is capture somebody's name and email and get them to go into your lead magnet, right? Now, that has worked, you know, in the last 5 years, but here's the thing, it's getting more expensive, and people are a lot more reluctant to give up their name and email. I want you to think about it like this. Getting somebody's name and email before you've built any value of giving them anything beforehand, it's kind of like going to a club and trying to get somebody's name and phone number in 30 seconds. It's tough, right? I don't know if it's easier here, but in Malaysia, it's tough. Okay, so, but however, if you start off the relationship by giving value first, by leading that relationship with value, that's kind of like going to a club, hanging out there for an hour, and kind of notice who's smiling at you. And then you approach them, and then you talk to them, right? So it's pretty much the same thing. So what's the ROI? What I do is sometimes I create videos, I do these live videos, I do pitches, I sell on Facebook, and then I boost it to the people that has consumed my content in the past. I can create ads. So like, for example, there's this video that says, for example, 7 figures and still poor, right? 13 million people watch this video. So what I would do is I would create an ad that says, hey, I noticed you watched my video on 7 figures and still poor. If you like to find out how you can change the quality of life, you might want to join us for this upcoming webinar. So notice I'm sending them to my webinar, but not sending it to a completely cold audience. I'm sending it to people that have consumed my stuff in the past, right? So I do. So you want, the next thing is you will always want to be marketing. So look, I went to Disney World like 2 days ago, right? 3 days ago. And I just launched a free plus shipping book offer. And what twisted individual would go to Disneyland with his physical book thinking about how to market it? This guy right here. So I went to Disneyland. I took pictures with the castle. I took pictures with Beauty and the Beast. I took pictures with Gaston. And I'm constantly thinking about, like, how would my ad look like with this picture with Gaston? You know what my book will be called? What the ad would say? It would say, Gaston would have closed Bell if he read this book, right? That's my ad right there, right? So I'm constantly thinking about how to make that happen. So let's talk about the long-term plan, right? Journey to 100,000 followers. How do you make this happen? So what you want to do is, once you start posting the videos, you want to boost it using video views. You boost it for video views. Doesn't need to be much, $20, right? And then you are going to use a plugin to invite people who like the video, who engage in the video, to like your page as well. So just because they like the video, it doesn't mean that they are following your page right now. Now, if you have less than 100,000 followers, Facebook allows you to do this. Once it's over 100,000, you don't get this advantage anymore. So you're gonna invite them to like your page. Now, you can do this by manually clicking on invite friends to like this page, or you could hire someone who works in like a click sweatshop and do it for you. Or you could use this plugin that automates it for you. Okay, so a couple of things here. So let's talk about long-term plan. You wanna get verified. Why you wanna do this as well? Once you get verified, Facebook, when you run Facebook ads, your chance of getting shut down decreases a whole lot less. Okay, now how many of you would like to find out the easiest proven way to get verified? Okay, thank you. Now once you get over 100,000 followers, here's what you do. You're going to take your book, you're going to write up a book, it doesn't need too long, maybe 50, 100 pages. You're going to put it up on Amazon. Now, here's the thing about Amazon. Everybody knows that it's easy to game the system today. You put it up on Amazon, you make it as a number one in like five categories, drilled down in five categories. You know what I'm talking about, right? So all you need is like 20 sales in that category that's drilled down five levels, right? Home business, biz ops, cooking, knitting, and you know, something like that, right? So five levels drilled down, make it to number one. Once it's number one, you're gonna take a screenshot. You take this screenshot, you submit it to Facebook, and that's how you get verified, right? Really easily. I've got a lot of my students have done it in the past. right? That's how you get verified easily. So here's the thing. I've got 3 minutes left, 2 minutes left. I want to share with you the number one thing that will stop you from implementing this. The only thing that will stop you from implementing this is you have to do step one. You can't outsource step one. You can't get someone else to do it for you. But here's the problem. How many of you here, very honestly, if I were to ask you to shoot videos in front of a camera, naturally, you will feel a little bit nervous. Can I see a show of hands? Okay, here's the thing. Here's the thing I want to share with you. I was brought up in an environment where my parents, they weren't business people, they weren't marketers. In fact, I was brought up on a farm. Okay, and one of the things that my dad would make me do when I was a kid is every single year he would bring me to the farm, to the same exact spot, and he would take this picture of how my brother and I is growing up together with the farm. He would be really proud of all the, you know, trees and all the fruits all growing up together, and he would document this. So I want you to understand that I was brought up in an environment where I didn't know how to do this, I learned it. I created my very first product, right, in the World of Warcraft market because I began as a gamer, and then I scaled it up when Facebook Games was a huge hit. But here's the thing I want to share with you. When I did this and I got my first break in the gaming market, I didn't have the confidence to market myself. I didn't want to be out there. In fact, I thought to myself, who's going to buy from this random Chinese guy from Malaysia named Ping Jun? I honestly did not have the confidence to do so. So you know what I did? For many years, in my first few years marketing online, I marketed under a pen name. So this product here, FarmVille Secrets, that was the number one bestseller in the gaming market for years, I marketed under a pen name called Tony Sanders, right? I'm Tony Sanders. I pretty much took Tony Robbins and Colonel Sanders, I merged them together. That was Tony Sanders, okay? So I didn't have to do that. So life was good. So I just wanted to be this shy, anonymous kid in the internet making big money online until this thing happened. I got an email from AWeber, and they shut me down literally overnight. And this was an outdated screenshot. I had a list of 650,000 people, and I lost my list overnight, just like that. And the worst thing was, they refused to give me a backup copy of my list. Is there any one of you that's on AWeber right now? Okay, you guys are screwed, okay? And that's why you gotta understand that when Russell announced Action Ethics and that you could send emails on Action Ethics, like, I literally jizzed in my pants. Okay, well, not the full load, just a little bit, okay? So here's the thing. I want to end with this, right? I want to end with this. Today, when people follow me and they see all of the things that I'm doing across all these things, speaking, closing, across all these different countries, it is easy to assume that it's talent, that, oh, Pingjun's naturally good at this. I want you to understand that every single skill in entrepreneurship, whether it's building funnels, whether it's writing copy, whether it's shooting videos, all these are learnable, trainable skills. I don't believe in talent. I believe in good habits, and all of us can choose good habits over talent. Hey guys, hey Funnel Hackers, it's an honor and a privilege to be here today. I believe that my work here is done, yours has just begun. Thank you all very much. Appreciate you guys.